on the live stream lounge here, we have Lynn Weaver, the founder of Three Weavers Brewing Company. Welcome,
hi there.
Lynn.
Thank you.
Nice to see you.
It's a pleasure. I feel honored. I get Chris. The Chris.
I don't know if I should be scared of that or not. Have I got a reputation? Are people talking about me out there?
All good. All good.
All right.
Yeah.
All positive things. So, you guys are a local brewery here to Southern California. Talk to me about what's happening just in the local market and what you guys are seeing out here.
Los Angeles, I just learned yesterday, we have about, I think, over 70 breweries within our county right now. And our county actually did fairly well at GABF recently, so we took a lot of medals home. So I'm really proud of our county breweries. So it says something to the nation in the sense of the quality of the beer that's being produced within Los Angeles.
It's really come a long way. I mean, for a while there, LA was kind of in the shadows of San Diego.
It was barely a blip underneath San Diego.
Yeah, it was like Golden Road showed up, and everyone was really excited. Then they sold to Anheuser-Busch, and everyone got really sour on that. And, you know, then there's all these amazing breweries that kind of sprouted up alongside them. And it seems like there's just a ton of enthusiasm for those brands now.
Well, I actually would say that Golden Road wasn't the first one to come up. There were several different, I would call them legacy breweries within Los Angeles that have been celebrating their 6th, 7th. Anniversaries that came well before Golden Road, and they're the ones who have kind of fostered this community aspect within our county, and it kind of fills through. We have very few breweries who are not part of our Brewers Guild, and we're also known as probably one of the reckoning forces as guilds-wise on a county level. Across the nation, just because we're well organized.
Yeah, made some noise earlier this year with the LA Galaxy and a beer fest. I mean, I saw a lot of stuff and a lot of chatter about the brands that they wanted to have at that festival.
I think more importantly was the World Series and Mary Garcetti pushing for the wrong beer.
Exactly. That was the most recent one. Mm-hmm. So certainly a vocal group. How about for Three Weavers? What are you guys gonna finish the year at? How are things looking just for your company?
We're doing really well. I think that growth is always difficult. When you plan something like installing large machinery, nothing always goes the way that you plan.
Sure.
Or wish to. So we're a little bit behind in the sense of where we wanted to be, but it doesn't mean that we're not going to get there. And it has to do with us shifting from on-premise, which we're pretty predominantly on-premise, and it's kind of odd for breweries how on-premise we are focused on our production-wise. But as we make that shift over to off-premise and the chain segment, then our numbers will just skyrocket more than we anticipate. But even right now, we're probably at 88% growth in our distributor level.
Wow. Yeah. And how much room do you guys have to grow just within your physical space?
We probably can get up to between 50 and 55,000 barrels.
Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm.
So you guys are ready to scale and ready to capitalize on opportunities that come your way.
That's right. So when we initially planned out the brewery, we kind of selected the building so that we can slowly take over units as we went along. So we've really strategically planned out the ability to drop in tanks as we go along. So
awesome. And where will you guys finish the year in terms of production?
I think that we'll probably be around 6,000. We're currently brewing at about an 8,500 barrel rate.
Wow.
But because of the delays with cans and our canning line, we kind of missed our mark of our goal originally. But you know what? That's life. You got to adapt and you got to kind of keep on going.
And now, is all the beer staying, for the most part, pretty local?
No, we are exploring other markets. We are also participating in some export. So we'll be sending some of our beer to Japan.
Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm.
Very cool. Where do you see just the future of your business going? I mean, you mentioned the export. I'm assuming probably just a small piece of what you guys are doing, but in terms of the growth opportunities at the distribution level, where do you see Three Weavers ending up over the next year or two?
California is a huge market. Los Angeles is the largest beer market in the United States, and it's our home market. We really don't want to have to focus very much further than Los Angeles, but I think our goal, ultimate goal, is really to conquer within California and to be really recognized as a California brand. And well known within the state of California. I think that with you know, 50,000 barrels of ability to produce, that could very well stay mostly in California.
Yeah.
And then we are able to control our quality a lot, you know, more closely. But it doesn't mean that we won't do some drop shipments, you know, on the East Coast or in other countries.
Nice. Yeah, I mean, I think you've seen companies like Firestone Walker have a lot of success with that, with their 805 brand. You know, that was just a local-only product for so long on the Central Coast, and it's, you know, it's starting to expand out into other markets now. But, you know, there is so much opportunity in California. There's so much opportunity in Southern California. It almost doesn't make much sense to, you know, really spread your wings far and wide if you're based here.
I would agree with that. We would consider Northern California just because Alexandra, our brewmaster, has her brewing roots somewhat in Northern California, so she's a bit recognized up there. But really, we're really focusing heavily in Southern California.
Awesome. So one of the other questions I wanted to ask you was, earlier this year, the Brewers Association established a committee on diversity, and you're a member of that committee, and you're also obviously the founder of an all-female-owned and operated brewery. How have the discussions in that committee gone so far? What have you learned? What have you guys been talking about? And what's been the sort of initial result of that committee just forming in general?
Well, we were founded or announced in April of 2017. So we're pretty new, 8 months into this whole entire endeavor. And it's going to take some time, to be totally honest. This year is supposed to be the research gathering year. And it gives us some time to be able to kind of go through that information that we're gathering at this point in time. It doesn't mean that we're not acting. We've already made suggestions as well as requests of the Brewers Association Board of Directors, which they're actually meeting today in Atlanta to review and to approve. I'm looking forward to see a lot of these items come to fruition. So, with regard to specifics, I'm not going to steal the Brewers Association's thunder, yeah. But I'll say this: 2017 is a research gathering year. 2018 is an action year.
Okay.
So there are going to be some groundbreaking tactics that we're going to be utilizing to address the discussion of diversity.
Okay, and in the areas of sort of labels and branding, I mean, I imagine that's got to be a focus. What other areas?
Well, I think that the labels and the branding side has already been addressed within the marketing and the guidelines within the Brewers Association. I think that it's more education driven and informing, and getting understanding and getting tools out to our members to assist them in having an understanding of what diversity is in the first place.
Sure.
And what is, you know, social sustainability, and how does that play into everything?
What does that look like for you guys as a company just here locally, you know, I guess beyond what you guys are already working on with the Brewers Association?
For Three Weavers, it's very interesting. We were asked a lot about our employment dynamic in the sense of who works at Three Weavers, and surprisingly, most of the roles are like management roles are actually held by women, and it wasn't intentional in any way. It just happened to be the person who was the best suited for the position.
Yeah.
So I think that we only have one, it sounds awful, but we only have one male that's in a managerial position, and two, and then there's probably five women. In the sense of Los Angeles, we're such a diverse melting pot already that when we're drawing applicants for any positions within our brewery, we already have such a wonderful mixed pot to be able to, you know, pull from.
Yeah.
So it's not the same for somebody who's, you know, in a different, like mid, you know.
Yeah, rural part of town.
That's correct.
Yeah, certainly.
Or country, part of the country. So, you know, it's difficult when you're looking at diversity in that manner, because it's not fair to have these requirements on, you know, a company where their demographic is very different than, say, Los Angeles, San Francisco, even Austin.
Right. Yeah, I mean, population centers are going to be the spot where you're going to find more businesses like Three Weavers, for sure.
Agreed.
Yeah. Well, I'll give you one final word. I know our time is up. One final word, something you're looking forward to beyond some of the diversity initiatives in 2018, maybe something that you guys are embarking on for Three Weavers.
Oh, let's see here. Cans. Lots of cans and a lot of chain. So we've been predominantly, like I said before, on-premise. In 2016, 90% of our beer was in draft. And now we are actually making that shift over into that on-premise push. So it's a pretty big game changer for us. A learning curve, but also quite exciting.
All right. Well, the second guest, Brett talked about cans. You talked about cans.
It's cans. Everything is cans.
Everything is cans. Yeah. I saw today that Oscar Blues is renaming their holding company to Canarchy. Cans all the way. Cans all
the way.
They're smart. Awesome. Thank you so
Take
much
care.
For joining us.
Thank you.
Cheers.